থেকে এখন স্টপ করা রেডিও মিউটার
It's live now. Okay. Good morning, one and all. I would like to welcome you all again to this Bed University virtual seminar series. And I'm very happy to see you again here. And today we're going to see some interesting topic on team building. Okay. And before that, I would also say, I was also suggesting about visiting the university and seeing our state of art infrastructure. So I would request all of you to come here and visit us, and you would be finding a lot of insights when you meet our team. Okay. So. So we have been discussing about the virtual seminar week, and we had a number of sessions on the previous days. The first session was by me, and I discussed about different career options. And if you have any questions, if you want to know about how to choose your careers, feel free to come and meet me. Okay, I will guide you through how to select career, because I have been guiding many students to select their careers in Uzbek University. And if you have confusions which course to select, and you can come and meet me. For example, you may be interested in some course, IT course, but you don't know whether you are suitable for that. So I would guide you with the right kind of assessments and interactions to find out your skills and match that skills with that course. Okay. So feel free to contact me. I'm Dr. Vivek, Senior Lecturer, ICT of HRM, and a Certified Career Analyst. And we had a session, interesting session by Dr. Tyagi Vaibhav Bhushan on Tuesday, which was for engineering as a profession. I already said people think engineering as a tough career, tough course. So there is a mental block. So what happens, this seminar was about to enlighten you about clearing that mental block, whether you can select engineering as a course and as a profession. Okay. And yesterday we had a session by Mr. Samantha Ronald on how universities can create entrepreneurs. We at Isbert University believe in job creators as well as job makers. We believe in job creators more. So we want to foster those entrepreneurs from university itself. Okay, so this initiative, this seminar was about giving you ideas, giving you insights about how the university is going to train you to become an entrepreneur. Okay, and today's session is going to be about the five secrets of building a cohesive team. So I used to say this team spirit or team effort, team spirit is something very, very important for every professional. Even as a student, you should have that team spirit, and you should be able to work as a team, as a cohesive team. Also, when you're doing a project or when you're in a profession, when you're going for a job, this kinds of skills is going to be very, very useful. Okay. And it is going to be conducted by Mr. Kauki James Stephen, and he is a faculty of business, and is going to get you through today. And tomorrow, last but not the least, the programming for a better future. And this seminar is all about giving you ideas about programming, why you should select programming, or what are the skills and aptitude needed to be a programmer. Okay. And this will clear all your doubts about being a programmer. Okay. And it is going to be done by Mr. Danish Edathan, who's an expertise in programming in IT. And he's a passionate teacher and is going to guide you through. Please don't miss it. Huh? And I just want to tell you something very interesting, very useful. We as a university believe in giving service to the students, we have this as a policy to help students who are not having good financial situations, financial things like that. So we are giving those bursaries for eligible students. And it's a one-time opportunity for you to get that. If you want to join a course and you're going to get a bursary, this is a great thing, right? So please don't miss this opportunity. Visit the campus and meet the team which is going to guide you, okay, in getting those bursaries. And you can also come and meet me anytime and I'll guide you through selecting your course, okay? So I would like to welcome once again Mr. Kawiki James Stephen, who was an expertise in communication skills as well as finance. So he is going to guide you through this interesting session. So I would like to welcome Mr. James. The floor is yours. Thank you.
Yes. All right. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's nice having you this morning. I know we are from different time horizons. So those in the afternoon, good afternoon. Those in the evening, good evening. And those in the morning, good morning. So it's nice having you this wonderful morning, depending where you are. My name is James Stephen Kawuche. Before I start, I believe we are aware that the success of any organization depends on teamwork, okay? How is the team organized? What goals do they have? What objectives do they have? What intentions do they have? So we need to understand the team. Also have to understand, why is the team being formulated? Is it important or relevant for an organization? So reaching success doesn't come by chance. It comes in if, say, we have well-leveled grounds, decisions are made, objectives are clear, and also having a good team, okay? I believe you have seen swarm of bees, they always move in a team. I believe you have seen the ants. I believe you have seen people in the army, they have to work as a team. I believe you have seen also people in different capacities, organization, where they have particular objectives and goals they have to achieve. But all these can only be achieved if, say, people are working in a good cohesive team. So you have to understand what a team is, okay? And Paul said, what are some of the major four criteria for formulating a team? And also get to know the secrets of building a cohesive team. However, as companies, organizations, institutions, and bodies of all different organizations have different goals and objectives, it doesn't mean that they should forget all about the individual goals, okay? So mean that now the organizational goals and objectives have to be the mainstream, and then these individual goals have to fit in, okay? So In order to achieve that umbrella goal, it means that now these individual goals have been looked at vividly, and also people have to work as one in order to achieve that major goal or objectives. So I believe you can see the illustration there. We're seeing people trying to work as a team. We are also seeing people moving in a team. So meaning that teamwork is important if success is to be achieved in one way or the other. All right, so let us ask us, let us get to know what a cohesive team is or what it implies. What a cohesive team is or what it implies. So you see that this cohesive team happens when a team remains united while working to achieve a common goal. I mean that if you look at achieving a common goal, we should see unity amongst people. When people are divided, then it ceases being a team. When people are divided, that means that now each one has their own motive or their own agenda. So if people work as one, united, and then they are looking at achieving the same goal, then we're talking about a cohesive team. Therefore, we see that being a cohesive team means that not only are group goals met, but everyone feels like they have contributed to the overall success of the group. So it means that we're not only looking at the group goals, but we're looking at the contribution of each individual to the success of the group, okay? Remember, people who are constituting to the team have different abilities, have also different disciplines, have also different skills. So if these people unite as one, that means that now it will be easier to attain or achieve the dream goals of the company, of the organization, and also any institution. Probably those who are out there, also you're thinking of joining university. When you come at the university, then you have to work as a team. You can't achieve success alone. You're going to seek help from different classmates, from different individuals. Those who are working in different companies also have to work in line with other individuals. At times, problems come along as you are progressing. Mean that you cannot achieve a particular goal or you cannot resolve that that problem alone. It requires input of other individuals. So teamwork is important and paramount if say success is to be achieved in one way or the other. So you see that individuals on the cohesive team tend to focus more on entire group rather than their individual selves and are motivated to work towards the team goal. So mean that now one will put aside his or her own interests and now will front the interests of the entire group. Okay? Mean that they put aside all their selfish interests and now they focus at achieving a common goal or a common objective. Because if you are dismantled, that means that you are no longer a team. It becomes so hard to attain or achieve success in an organization. And you find that whenever you have a common goal, this is how it drives you towards achieving it. This is how it inspires you. It inculcates you to work more harder towards achieving that. So you're going to look at a prominent scholar, that is Bruce Tuckman, okay? He's a researcher and he focuses on the four major stages of team development, okay? If you're to achieve a good team's cohesiveness, okay? And Tuckman is focusing on four components. We're looking at forming, storming, norming, and performing. Okay? All right. So, sorry for that interruption. So, we're looking at Team Cohesive, and now we are going to focus on Bruce Tuckman. Okay. Bruce Tuckman is a renowned researcher trying to look at cohesive teams. And he said that for us to have a cohesive team, then there are four major stages that have been looked at vividly. He's looking at forming, storming, norming, and performing. But when all these are put into place, then it is easier to achieve success in an organization. Okay? That's why I say that by understanding these stages, leaders and team members can understand why certain behaviors are happening and make informed changes. Okay? Mean that if you have an organization, if you have a company, one way or the other, people's behaviors will keep on changing. You as a leader, you have to understand, you have to know, why are people changing their behaviors? What is happening? What's wrong? What can be done in order to improve or to create change in whatever that is happening? So we're going to look at each of these stages and try to understand what is meant or what has to be done under each stage. Right? So if you look at the first stage, that is forming, as you look at the word forming, it's more of formulating. Okay? This is where people come to get to know each other. They do some kind of comparisons. They do some kind of social assessments. Find out, you say, they are fit to belong to a particular community or to be part of a particular society. Okay? So you get to know each other. So that's why we say that when employees are new to a team, or a new team is being built, okay? Whenever people are new, that means that now a new team has to be formulated, because now you're getting new members to the group, okay? So that's why I said that these new people need to get some time in order to adjust to the new environment, the new changes, to understand what has to be done, to understand the boundaries within the community they are, to discover how the team functions overall. Okay? So you need to understand the team. Okay? You need to get to know the environment where you are. Okay? You have to know the do's and the don'ts within a particular community where you are. So we're saying that we have to look at forming, okay, as our first stage. Okay? Forming, where we have to get to know each other, doing some kind of comparisons and also some kind of social assessments. So you see that team members, therefore, can help team members in the formation phase, okay? How can they do this? They can only do this if they set clear objectives. So if objectives are not clear, that means that now people are going to move headless. They're going to be wandering around. They don't have anything that is giving them a sense of direction. So you as a leader, you have to give them clear objectives. This will show them clear sense of direction. What has to be done? So that now people do not deviate from what is intended or what has to be achieved or acquired. Secondly, as team leaders, you have to establish both group and individual goals for each member, okay? Remember, you have formulated a group. Now, you have to know the goals of a group and also an individual, okay? So now, when people are working as a team, they should know, what are we aiming at? Then you as an individual, what do you want to achieve at the end of it all? Is it success? You want to improve your ability, your capacity? And thirdly, implementing team building activities to allow members to get to know one another. So once people know their goals and also the goal of the group, then you have to create time whereby now people get to know each other, okay? This team building has to come in activities. I believe you have seen people in different companies. There are times whereby they have to go for team building. They get to know each other. They get to understand each other, how somebody reasons, how somebody thinks, because you find that when people are in the same place over and again, they get bored. So creativity dies out. You never get to know who belongs to which group, who does what. But in these team building activities, people open up, okay? People open up, they get to understand each other, they become more creative, they become more innovative. And also, if so there's any kind of problem, then there's a way they can support each other. Cohesiveness comes in order to improve the performance and also to make sure that now the goal of an organization, the goal of a group is easily met. So we have to look at those three aspects when you're looking at forming. So he talks about the second stage, that is storming. And now this is also another important and relevant stage, storming. In a group, one way or the other, there are conflicts. In the initial stages, there are always conflicts. People will fight. Remember, people come as a team with different goals, okay? So when they're in there, people have different objectives. Right, so we see that people usually have conflicts. They have different intentions. They have different objectives. So in the initial stages of a group, people are not moving at the same pace, okay? They think differently. They want things that are different from the rest. So one way or the other, there are always conflict, quarrel. There'll be some kind of misunderstandings, okay? So mean that when we talk about storming, we look at conflicts, okay? Conflicts come in if say the roles are not well stipulated. One does not know what he or she has to do, who's responsible for what, when, okay? Mean that if somebody keeps on stepping on the toes of the other, then it creates some kind of conflicts, quarrels, and misunderstandings. So that's why I said that team members may often experience emotional resistance and may show behavior consistent with wanting to fulfill their individual goals rather than work as teams. That if people come in and then they have their own interests, they will always aim at achieving their own interests and they forget the umbrella goal of the team. So when they forget and they're focusing on their individual goals and objectives, definitely they're going to cause some kind of conflicts, some kind of infights, which will not be healthy for the team and also an organization or as a group. So therefore, we see that teammates may become defensive about the way things are done or should be done. And managers may often experience pushbacks. And if the team is in this kind of phase, then there are some important components that you as a manager, as a team leader, you need to focus on. So you as a manager, there's certainly aspects that you don't need to miss out. And one of them is establish structures and procedures that are followed by all team members. So conflicts will come in if structures are not clear. One does not know his responsibilities, his duties, his roles, okay? So you find that one crosses others' responsibilities or others' paths, and now then conflicts spark off. But if, say, we have structures well aligned, Okay? You know who is answerable to who? If there is any kind of problem, to whom should somebody report? Or how can something be resolved? Which procedure or formalities that have to be followed? Then conflicts won't be there. So to avoid all these kind of quarrels, issues, then structures and procedures should be well laid and communicated to the group members. Secondly, resolve conflicts as they occur. That in a team, once a particular problem occurs, try to resolve it there and then. Do not prolong, do not hold something that you solve it another year. No, that's not how it works. When something occurs, try to resolve it there and then when it is still fresh. Okay? Try to resolve the issue. And we see that in this kind of resolving a problem, then communication is paramount. Communication is the key. Okay? I say that it's important for individuals, team members, and management to feel comfortable expressing themselves. I believe you have seen some companies, they have what we call the open door policy. If somebody goes, probably somebody has any kind of grievance or any kind of issue, they can walk in and air out their issues. Okay? Mean that if you detach yourself or if you distance yourself from the members, then also it will be hard to know what problems or issues they are facing. So, hit the nail on the head when still hot. That's when a particular problem can be resolved. Do not extend or do not prolong or take forever to solve a particular issue. Then thirdly, we say that you should explain these stages to team members so they can have better understanding as to why conflicts arise. When procedures are known, structures are well laid, and also conflicts are solved there and then by putting proper communication channels, then try to communicate to the team members that if say a particular issue comes in, what has to be done? What has befallen? Then when people are in the know of what has been done, then it becomes easier to solve the issues or problem within the team. Then the third stage is what we call norming, okay? And you see that this one marks the point where conflicts begin to get resolved and are being replaced with cooperation. So maybe now people have now understood each other, the grudges or the issues they had, now they have put them aside. Now they're working as a one single team. Okay? They're working as a group. They understand each other. They have come to know their responsibilities, their roles, and why they're in a particular group. So you see that here we have to focus on unity. Because when you are united, you all move in the same direction. You will all aim at achieving the same goal or the same objective. So that's why I said that unity is established between individuals and members. Begin to unite their efforts and work together in order to pursue a common goal. So whenever people are united, they'll all be looking at a common goal or a common objective. Okay, and that's why I say that the group norms are established and members often feel comfortable giving feedback to each other. Okay, mean that if somebody opens up, if somebody understands each other, mean that now even the trust will be built. One will be in position to confide in the other because now he or she understands the other. They're all moving towards the same common goal. So there shouldn't be any kind of struggles, fights. No. Here we should look at having unity. Okay? So you say that unity is in stage three, that is norming. So you see that when unity is achieved, then we're saying that there are certain important components that have been focused on. Okay? One of them is having consistent meetings to ensure that everyone is still working towards the same goal and adjust as time goes on. Okay? So when people are united, to ensure that unity goes on, people don't lose track, then we should have meetings over and over again so that people are reminded, why are we here? What do we need to achieve? If there are any kind of deviations, any kind of loopholes here and there, now, through this kind of meetings, that's when all these kind of loopholes are solved or they are resolved. Okay? Mean that if somebody doesn't have consistent meetings, that means that now, chances are higher that people will forget. People will forget. People will go astray. People will focus on their individual goals and then they'll forget the common goal of a group. Secondly, allow team members' autonomy to work towards their goals. Okay? So, mean that if you have unity, as well as people, they are moving towards a common goal, also give them room, okay, to work also towards their goals. Okay? You might be employed somewhere and you're working towards a common goal or the umbrella goal. But that doesn't mean that you should forget your own goals or your personal goals. Okay? So wherever you are, you as an individual, one way or the other, you have your own goals. So allow members to also work towards their goals as they are working towards the umbrella goal. Because if you focus only on the common goal and you don't give them room to explore, also try to build themselves towards working their goals, then these people will lose the enthusiasm, they'll lose that spirit of working as a team. And lastly, continue to implement team building activities, both inside and outside the workplace, to keep communicating openly and also in order to ensure that people are actively involved in an organization. Okay? Mean that once unity there is there, then enable team building activities, they should be there. Okay? Mean that now people should be taken even outside the perimeters of an organization, the company or an institution. Okay? Can go to the beach, possibly go to a particular hotel, possibly go to a particular country. So now people's minds open up. People are free themselves. People are in position to share. They're in position to associate. Okay? With that, you'll be in position to discover the abilities of other individuals. Okay? My friend, that in an entire organization, there's some people you have never met, some people you have never talked to. But in this kind of team building activities, you'll be in position to meet a variety of individuals. Okay? My friend, the process, all along you have been facing a particular problem and you didn't know which person to run to in order to solve it. But through this kind of team building activities, then you'll be in position to identify or get to know those individuals who will be in position to give you support or share ideas. Okay? So it means that in these team building activities, people open up. Okay? People will be in position to discover themselves, be in position to associate one or the other, and also help oneself. Then the fourth stage, which is the most exciting stage, is performing. It is performing. In this kind of performing, we're saying that it is the optimal level, meaning each person is concerned with team success rather than solely individual recognition. So I mean that here, everyone is aiming at success. They're not looking at being recognized as an individual. They want success to go to the entire team, the entire company, the entire group. They're not looking at self-recognition. So that's why I said that each person feels like they have a purpose and they are valued. They have a purpose and they're making a positive contribution to the success of an organization. So you said that each person understands that their contributions are important and they should be willing to take risks. If, say, they believe they'll benefit the team. Okay? So everybody will bring in their contribution. Everyone will bring in their views because they're all aiming at success. When they achieve success, then the entire organization, the entire company will benefit. So that is the fourth stage. So you see that in this kind of success or performing, teams who progress to performing stage understand how beneficial teamwork is in attaining the goals that they have set out to achieve. Okay? But if you reach this fourth stage, then you'll be in position to understand the benefit of teamwork. Because all of you, you're going to be working towards the same goal or towards the same objective. So you see that this team possess a true sense of team cohesion. And once your team have reached this kind of stage, then there are certain important concepts that have been realized or articulated in this kind of stage. One of them is celebrating your victory. You as a team, you have gone through hardships. Okay? So mean that once success is achieved, then it's worth to celebrate. It's not a bed of roses. It's not a smooth journey. Remember, we said that in stage two, there are conflicts. So there's some kind of hurdles, hardships that were there. Or you find that you had a particular objective, but it was so hard to achieve. There are fights there. But once success achieved, then it's worth it to celebrate because it wasn't that easy. Also, forecast and target new goals. So as you celebrate, now you should be thinking of what next. Now you have achieved this. Now, what are we aiming at? What should we focus on as time goes on? Okay? So as you celebrate, think about the future. What new goals do you have? So focus and target new goals while continuing to achieve consistent meetings to ensure everyone is on the same page. So mean that the success you have achieved, it should not block your future. So constantly have meetings and try to engage team members about the future. Where are we going? Now we are here. Where are we going? What next? What do we need? Or what is required for us to move to that next level? Thirdly, allow the team some room to make decisions. You should not always be the fountain of everything. No, give also these team members some room to make decisions. Okay? So over-controlling at this stage may cause team to regress back to lower stages. It's not always that you're the alpha and the omega of everything. No, give the team members a room to make decisions. You may find that these team members can make even better decisions than you as a team leader would make. Remember, the team is composed of a variety of individuals with different exposures, experience, different knowledge. So if you give them that kind of room to exercise decision making, then trust me, you're making the right choice. Okay? Remember, these people are the ones that have their hands on. They know what is happening at the places of work. They know what is happening in the market. They know what is happening on the ground. So give them room to make decisions. Okay? If you give them room, this is how they feel comfortable. They become part and parcel of the organization. They'll be more dedicated. They'll be more thrilled, energized to even go beyond the bar to perform and ensure that the company achieves success. So you see that it's important to note that teams will fluctuate throughout these stages, especially when new team members join and others leave. Okay? Why do we say so? So as time goes on, you may find that some people become old, some people's energy reduce, or some people get other greener pastures. So mean that now the team will not be as it used. One way or the other, there's going to be some kind of deterioration in performance. So means that now it's important to know, why are we deteriorating? We need to replace so and so. But then, are we getting the right people or the right pattern to replace the people who were once there? And we also need to note that the people who are joining, they are new. They don't know how everything works in a team or in a group. Okay, so we should know that it will not always be a success. There are always some kind of flaw, some kind of hiccups here and there. So we need to know, how do we then try to resolve that? So you see that team cohesion is important in the workplace, as leads to greater company success, improved employment or employee satisfaction, and also increased motivation. So whenever people work in a team, in a group, then definitely it's easier to get success. I believe some of you are fans of football. When Arsenal is playing, the Arsenal fans, they are all roulating, jubilating, Barca, Man U, Liverpool, name it. But you find that any of those teams, they can only achieve a win or success if they work as a team. In the army, you can only win the battle and war when you work as a team. Okay? So teamwork or team cohesion is the key to success of an organization. And also, people get thrilled when they're working as a team. Okay? Meaning that working in isolation is not that simple. Okay? But if say you're in a team, there's a way one will push you, one will support you, one will remind you, and also you'll be motivated to perform even beyond what you can. We also see that this kind of team cohesion can be learned. You see what others are doing, then you come up with your own team and try to work towards that. So you say that although teams must treat the process organically, it is important to remember that communication is key and roles must be defined clearly. So if you think of formulating teams or working teams, then you should communicate. And also the roles, the duties, the responsibilities of each person have to be clearly defined. When the roles and responsibilities, the duties are not well stipulated or spelled out, that's where I find that people are crossing lines and now conflicts, arguments come up. So we're saying that communication has to be one of the most important issues, and also the roles have to be well spelled out in order to have success or to have a good team. So the team can be small or large, and basically locally or international. So when we talk about a cohesive team, it can be a team of 3 people, 5 people. It can be a team of 20 people, 30 people. It can be a team within the same community, or it can be a team where we're having people from different communities, different countries, then formulate a team. But we also need to understand the dynamics that happen in teams. So you say that no matter what the team dynamic, all team members must have clear understanding of their individual roles. So one has to understand his responsibility, his duty. One has to understand the goals of the team. One must trust each person. One must have that kind of self-drive in order to achieve a goal and objective of a team, to ensure that success is achieved in one way or other. So we move now to the 5 secrets. The 5 secrets, which that there's several factors that have to decide whether team wins or loses. But there is one thing that all truly success teams have in common, is being cohesive, unity, working as one. If you are divided, then you're no longer one. Meaning now you have different thoughts, different ideologies. Okay, I believe I've seen different organization process getting dismantled or collapsing, different governments collapsing because of not working as a team. So it is important to understand teamwork. We have to work as a unity, as one. So this cohesive team, it is a complete game. It is a game changer when people perform as a united entity with a shared vision, rather than merely working together as a group or people with diverging or ever conflicting agendas. So it means that for the teamwork, we should have a common vision. We should have the same agenda. We should be on the same page. If you are all in different pages or on different pages, then you never move in the same direction. So you see that cohesive teams speak the same language. If it's attack, attack. If it is to sell, you sell. If say, if you are to move forward, you move forward. If you're to expand the clientele, you expand the clientele. You're all speaking the same language, okay? You know how to focus and you are all moving towards the same goal or towards the same cause. So I say that such teams are much stronger than the sum of their parts. That if you have the same goal, you're speaking the same language, you have the same common understanding, then you be strong. You be stronger than the pillars of any building on this planet Earth. But if, say, you're all thinking otherwise, there's no unity, you're all at different wavelengths, then weakness comes in and now trouble will come in. So drop it up. These five secrets are trust-based vulnerability. Trust. Once trust is not in there, then teamwork will never be there. Success will not be achieved. Trust-based vulnerability. Do you trust each other? Do you trust each other? I believe you have come across particular individuals. One wants to do something, but then the trust is not there. Then somebody holds back. So trust is the foundation for team cohesiveness and achieving a particular goal and objective. Because you trust each other, you've been positioned to share, you've been positioned to brainstorm, being positioned to come up with ideas, be open to each other on how best you can solve a particular issue. Secondly is productive conflicts. Productive conflicts. With this, we are saying that you should not be engaged in unproductive conflicts, because these unproductive conflicts will not take the company, the organization, the institution to the next level. But if you have productive conflicts, whereby these conflicts are beneficial to the company, people are coming up with ideas, people are criticizing each other productively, okay? There's a way one will try to think on how to improve on his idea, on his thoughts, mechanisms, methods of doing particular issues. But if today you are engaged in these unproductive conflicts, or say gossip, or say doing funny things, then it will be hard to achieve particular goals. In fact, with this, we said we should avoid unproductive conflicts or cheap politics, because that will never benefit a company in one way or the other. Finally, commitment to decisions. Once you have decided that you are going to do a particular issue, one has to be dedicated towards achieving a particular goal. Whatever you have decided on, make sure that you implement it. Be committed to it. Do not deviate. You should stick on it, make sure that you achieve or you accomplish your dream goal and objectives. In fact, with this, you even have to go an extra mile beyond what is expected out of you. If it means spending some kind of sleepless nights, it means, Paul said, traveling, if it means engaging different individuals of all kinds, then it will be easier to achieve a particular goal or a particular success. Then fourthly, mutual accountability, that whatever you do, you should be held accountable. Not also to say that it was so and so, it's not me, no. I mean that if there's that kind of mutual accountability, then one will be dedicated, one will be focused, one will be committed to whatever he's doing because he is accountable or he knows that he will be answerable to whatever he's doing or whatever he has to do or he is yet to do. So accountable, you should be held accountable. If things go wrong, you should be answerable. You should be positioned to explain what happened, what went wrong, okay? Then lastly is result focused, okay? That for any cohesive team, you should aim at obtaining particular results. Or one can say, goal-oriented. When you have a particular goal, there's a way all your activities, all your thoughts, whatever you have in mind, it will be on achieving that goal or achieving that objective. So being result-oriented, it keeps your mind focused. Whatever you're doing, whatever component you are going to do, it is all going to be focused on achieving a particular goal. So those are the five secrets of a cohesive team. That is trust-based vulnerability, productive conflict, commitment to decisions, mutual accountability, and result focused. So that's what I had for you today. I believe one or the other, you have benefited from this discussion regarding the five secrets of a cohesive team or building a cohesive team. So if you think of building any kind of team, then these are some of the important components that you should think about. Even those who are dreaming at joining Eastbat University, then you should also keep this in mind, okay? Keep this in mind. You should trust the people who are going to deliver service to you, engage in productive conflicts. If there are quizzes, there are debates, there are activities, you should be engaged, okay? If say something has been decided, make sure that you are part and parcel of all the activities that are happening, do not deviate, okay? And also you should be held accountable for whatever actions that you do, and also you should aim at getting any kind of results. You should be result-oriented in all your activities, okay? So thank you all for attending, and thank you for choosing Eastbat University. And in case of any questions, please do not hesitate to log in our Wisdom channel and also to get in touch with us. Thank you all for attending. God bless you all. Any questions, ladies and gentlemen? If you have any question, feel free to ask me any question. Well, Eastbat is a place to be because Eastbat provides the best services. It's a university of the best technology, okay? When the world was hit by the pandemic, ISPA did not stop. It continued providing education services to the students, learners all in different countries, different parts of the world. So if you think of any university to join, ISPA is the best university to join because it provides all the necessary facilities to you, all the best technology, and we're in position to serve you at all time. Wow, somebody's asking, when will this year's semester for the new students begin? Wow, the semester is beginning, that is 27th of this month, so September, okay? That is for continuing for the new ones. It will start literally, that will be in October, first week of October. But official communication will be passed for those, to all those who have enrolled for this semester. So I believe also you have also communication channels that you have access to. There are communication channels that we have, which you can use if say you want any kind of inquiry, if you're seeking for any kind of inquiry. So please do not hesitate to ask us any question, okay? Any query, okay? So the start date will be communicated to you soon for the new students, okay? So be ready. What I can say that you should be ready to start. And the good thing, we have the best technology, which means that anytime you've been possible to achieve or access our services at any point, at any time, and in any place. But for the continuing students, that is 27th of September, and then for the new students, that will be the first week of October. If there's not any question, then we can call it a day. Thank you all for tuning in to this session. God bless you and see you once again.
Okay. Any questions?